Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Planet. Friends, this is our first session for algebraic identities. Friends, in the previous classes, you might have learned about algebraic expressions. You might have learned about their addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. You must have done factorizations as well, right? So, good number of algebraic results you might have learned, right? So I just have a quick recap of some of the results over here. So I just write down the results over here. Suppose a plus b whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Similarly, a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square, then a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. Similarly, a plus b plus c whole square is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus bc plus ac, right? That we have a plus b whole cube, that is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab a plus b. Then we have a minus b whole cube, that is a cube minus b cube minus 3ab a minus b. Then suppose we have a cube plus b cube, that is a plus b a square minus ab plus b square. Then we have a cube minus b cube, that is a minus b. Then a square plus ab plus b square, right? Then one very important identity is a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc is equal to a plus b plus c, and then a square plus b square plus c square minus ab minus bc minus ac. In this particular case, if a plus b plus c is equal to 0, that means if this term is 0, the entire right hand side will be multiplied by 0, so the entire right hand side will be 0. So if a plus b plus c is 0, a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc will be 0, that means a cube plus b cube plus c cube will be equal to 3abc, right? So that's an important result, right? So all of these we have already learnt in our junior classes, right? See, all these results are known as identities, or we can say algebraic identities, because all these results are true for any variable. Here we have taken a and b. Instead of a and b, if we use x and y, then also it's true. If we take any numeric value for a and b, then also the results will be true, right? So we call them algebraic identities. And we use all these algebraic identities in the factorization of algebraic expressions and polynomials, right? So all the identities are really very important. In fact, in case when we have to find out the product of algebraic expressions, then also we can use these identities, right? So let's discuss problems based on algebraic identities now. Now suppose I have to find maybe 2x plus y whole square, right? So what identities can be used over here? That is a plus b whole square. That is a square plus 2ab plus b square, right? So here a is 2x and b is y, right? So just put the value of a and b over here in this expansion and we'll be getting the product, that is 2x plus y whole square, right? So I put a as 2x and y as b, b as y, right? So it's 2x plus y whole square is equal to a square, that means 2x whole square plus 2, a is 2x, so into 2x, b is y, so into y, plus b square, that means y square. So finally it is 4x square plus 4xy plus y square. So the expansion of 2x plus y whole square is 4x square plus 4xy plus y square, right? Similarly, suppose I take 3x minus 4y whole square. In this case, we can use the identity a minus b whole square, that is a square minus 2ab plus b square, right? Gradually, you just try to understand this thing. Just compare a as 3x and b as 4y, right? And directly you can put the values over here, right? As I'm doing over here, just watch it carefully. A square, a is 3x, so it is 3x whole square minus 2 into a into b, that is 3x into 4y, right? Plus b square, b is what? 4y, so it's 4y whole square. Now just expand it, it is 9x square minus 4, 3s are 12, 2s are 24xy plus 16 y square, right? And this is the expansion of this expression, okay? Similarly, we take more of them. Suppose I am having maybe x plus 1 upon maybe 3x whole square, right? Further, it's a plus b whole square. Here a is x and b is 1 upon 3x, right? So first of all, a square, that is x square, then 2, this into this, then square of this, right? So it is x square plus this x will be cancelled. So it is 2 by 3 plus 1 upon 9x square, right? So this is the expansion of this expression. Isn't it simple? You can take various questions and practice as well. Now suppose I am having x by 3 minus y by 2 whole square. Now this is what? A minus b whole square, right? So that's a square minus 2ab plus b square, right? So square of this minus 2, this into this, plus square of this, right? So this is x square by 9 minus xy by 3 plus y square by 4. That is the expansion of this, okay? Next is, suppose I have maybe root 2x minus root 3y whole square, right? So this is what? A minus b whole square. So first of all, square of this. So this is a square of this minus 2, this into this, then plus square of this. Okay, so it is 2x square minus 2 into root 2 into root 3 will be root 6, xy plus root 3 square will be 3 and y square will be y square. So it's 2x square minus 2 root 6 xy plus 3y square, right? Now suppose I have maybe 2x plus 5y into 2x minus 5y. Now we have discussed a minus b into a plus b is equal to a square minus b square, right? So there is two variable a and b, and once there is minus between them and once there is plus between them, right? The same thing is over here, that is this and this is same and this is same, and once there is a plus sign and then there is minus sign between the two, right? So you can directly put this, you can directly use this identity, right? That means square of this minus square of this, right? So it is square of this minus square of this, right? But you have to mention this identity in your exams, right? So that you are using this identity. So it's 4x square minus 25y square, right? Similarly, suppose you have x minus 1 upon y and x plus 1 upon y, right? So it's a minus b into a plus b format, right? So square of this minus square of this. So x square minus 1 upon y square, right? If you have root 2x minus maybe 3y into root 2x plus 3y. So further you have a minus b into a plus b format. So further square of this minus square of this. So it's square of this minus square of this, right? So it's 2x square minus 9y square, okay? Now let's take up more problems. In this case, we have to evaluate the identities. Here it's, you can just verify the pattern that it is a minus b whole square, right? So what a minus b whole square is? A square minus 2ab plus b square. Here a is 2x and b is 1 upon x, right? So simply what you have to do, square of this, that is 2x whole square minus 2, a is 2x into b is 1 upon x plus 1 upon x whole square. This is the first step. Then second step, just open it. 4x square minus x and x is cancelled. 4 plus 1 upon x square, right? So this is the expansion of this, okay? Now this is a plus b into a minus b format, right? So it's what? A plus b, a minus b is a square minus b square, right? So it's what? Square of this minus square of this, okay? So square of this minus square of this. So it is 4x square minus y square, right? Similarly here it is a minus b whole square, right? That means the pattern is x minus y whole square or a minus b whole square, right? So what that will be, I have written already here. It's square of this minus 2 times this into this plus square of this, right? So square of a square b minus 2 times this into this. So a square b into b square a plus square of this, right? So it's a square b whole square will be what? A4 b square minus 2. It's a cube b cube and plus b4 a square, right? So this is the expansion of this. I hope you are getting it. Similarly, it is a minus b into a plus b, that means it's a square minus b square format. So square of this minus square of this. So it's a square minus 0.1 whole square, that means a square minus 0.01, right? So simply you have to apply the identities all in this in all these cases, right? Similarly, just see, this is a minus b, this is a plus b, right? So a minus b into a plus b will be a square minus b square, right? So this is a and we have to square it. minus this is b, and we have to square it, right? Do not forget to put the datas in this bracket, right? Now open the bracket. So 1.5 square will be what? 2.25. x square is square is x core, minus 0.3 whole square will be 0.09, and y square will be y 4, right? So do not miss this step, otherwise you will make mistake, right? You have to put up the data in bracket. Okay, I hope you are clear now. Now friends, here are some important questions. Let's discuss. All of these questions can be solved by using algebraic identities very easily, right? But you have to you should be able to identify that which algebraic identity can be used over here, right? Now here we have to find out 399 square, right? Now 399 is what? Closer to 400, just one less than 400. So what we can do is we can write 400 minus 1, that's 399, and we have to take the square of that. So 400 minus 1 whole square, right? Do not make any mistake. 399 is written as 400 minus 1. So square of 399 will be square of 400 minus 1. Now this is a minus b whole square, right? Now you can expand this using a minus b whole square. So what a minus b whole square is? A square minus 2ab, so 2 into 400 into 1, plus b square, right? Now 400 square will be what? 4 square is 16, square of 100 will be 0000 minus 800 plus 1, right? So now you have to make this very simple calculation. So that is 15921, right? So simply we have solved it. So this method is rather easier than to find out the square of 399, that means to multiply 399 to 399, right? So this method is easier, and definitely at least one question will be asked on the same pattern in your exams, right? Similarly here it is 0.98 whole square. So 0.98 can be written as 1 minus 0.02, right? So instead of 0.98, I am writing 1 minus 0.02. So to get square, I need to square the entire expression, right? Now it is further a minus b whole square. So further expand it as a square minus 2ab plus b square. So a square is what? 1 square minus 2, this into this, right, plus square of this. Okay, so it's 1 minus 0.04 plus it's 400 this. Sorry, one more zero will be there. So it's 1 minus 0.04 plus 0.0004. So that's 0.9604, right? So this way you can solve this problem. Similarly, it is 991 into 83. Sorry, this is by mistake. So it is 991 into 1009, right? So now this is what? It is 1000 minus 9, it is 1000 plus 9. So I just write it over here. 1000 minus 9, 1000 plus 9. Now this is what? A minus b into a plus b format, right? So a minus b into a plus b will be what? A square minus b square. That means square of this minus square of this. So 1000 square minus 9 square. Now what will be 1000 square? It is 30, there is 30. Now in square there will be 6 zeros minus 81, right? So from this you need to deduct 81. So that is 999919. Okay, I'm sure you are getting me. Similarly, we can calculate 117 into 83. That's 100 plus 17, and this is 100 minus 17. So further it is a plus b into a minus b format. So it will be a square minus b square. That means square of this minus square of this. Right? So it's 10000 minus 289. That's 10,000 minus 289. So that is 9711. Right? So simply we have solved it if you know the algebraic identities. Right? Our friends will be taking problems, more problems and identities in our next session. So do revise this session before you come to the next session. Right? Bye-bye.